What up? It's Machine Gun Kelly, and I'm here with the good guys.
This one's for the Ratchet, Ratchet. Yeah. All my
Ratchet. Nah, Steph, hold on, man. They're not ready for that, man. You gotta play like another joint before you get to that one, man.
OBG.
There we go.
Lowe's.
New Fish Montana.
Lowe's.
MGK.
Original Bad Boy Gang.
What they talking about?
Hey, them niggas talking what they talking about.
What they talking about.
Montana niggas talking what they talking about.
We gon' start throwing each other out every week.
See them at niggas from the side watching, huh? Got $100,000 in my side pocket.
Talk just
all the hustlers love it.
French.
No, I speak the language.
You know what we
do. Told that bitch, give me head. Ocho Cinco.
Ocho Cinco. Ocho Cinco.
Don't let bitch give me head. Ocho Cinco.
Ocho Cinco. Ocho Cinco.
I just did outlandish things like pull up on, you know, pull up to high schools, you know, every fucking high school on the east side, hand out my CDs. Already it was just awkward because it's a white boy, it's a rapper, and you're in, you know what I'm saying, areas that you don't see white boys in. And I would just stand out, and I would just take that, you know, embarrassment that comes with, you know, people looking at you all crazy, dropping your CD on the ground, throwing it, not caring, not wanting to listen. But, you know, as long as I snagged, you know, one person that would listen to it every stop I went to, you know, I was down with it. And then when that one person would listen, they would see something special and spread the word. So that's pretty much how I just did it, man. It was just word of mouth. This is before the internet was really a big part of the game. This is before blogs hit. You know, I got all my stuff organically. And then when I got signed, I mean, I pretty much just depended on my, you know, the clout that I have in the city and, you know, and the intenseness of my fans, because that's what carried, that's what made people take me seriously, because they knew how, they knew that I actually had hometown love, which most rappers don't have. And then, you know, they knew that if you got on my bad side, my fans would let you have it. I think just the setup of a city is impossible to not make it in if you lock a city down, just because what a city is just a center for people to go in and out of. So, you know, it's not just people going in, it's people going out. So, you know, I was locking high schools down, but those kids eventually left to college. And when they left to college, they took that word and that hometown pride of Machine Gun Kelly with them to whatever college they went to. So it could be Ohio University, which is 4 hours away, or it could be Boston University, which is like, you know, probably 15 hours away, you know what I'm saying? So, any city you can, because that's how a city's set up. People are meant to go in it, people are meant to go out of it. So if you go in it and you're all they can talk about, they're gonna leave with that too. The Cleveland hip hop scene, real small, real well known, because everybody knows who's hot in the city. And I mean, now it should be more supportive. So I mean, I just started like a motherfucker, but I think it's in a positive place right now. Everyone knows who's coming up. Everyone knows who's there to mentor and who's there to, you know, everyone knows what's up. You know what I'm saying? So I think it's a positive state right now. And I mean, I've always been a fan of the music. When I listen to a lot of my iPod, man, that's a lot of Cleveland music more than any other music, for real. Just because it's special to me, because I know the rest of the world doesn't know it, you know what I'm saying? Advice I have for a Cleveland artist, dude, politics, man. Get cool with people. If you get cool with somebody, man, they're going to want to do stuff for you, man. Flat out. If you're angry and you whine, you know what I'm saying? I went through my whiny stage. Didn't get me nowhere, trust me. So if you sit there and you know what I'm saying, act like a civil motherfucker and you really appreciate what people, you know what I'm saying, are willing to give to you, or what opportunities people have opened for you, even if you don't have hand-to-hand contact with somebody, you know what I'm saying, always appreciate, you know what I'm saying, never depend on no grown, if you're a grown man, you should never depend on another grown man to get you put on, you know what I'm saying?
Nice.
You should just, you know, build the relationships yourself.
Z1079, Cleveland's number one for hip-hop and R&B, home of the Ricky Smiley Morning Show, 9 o'clock mixtape, Mr. Steph Floss. Sir, you are showing out. You doing too much.
I'm just trying, man. You know, I got my guy Machine Gun Kelly in here, man. He brought the new joint. Big, big, big shout-out to my man EV, what's popping. Big shout-out to Pooh Gutter. Free Pooh Gutter. Dubbo in the building with us right now.
Dubbo in the building.
We got Tezo, JP in the building on the track.
Ray Jr., Tezo, yup.
Man,
the whole,
track
all
is crazy.
All corners of the city, man.
Track is crazy.
I'm different, yeah, I'm different. I'm different, yeah, I'm different.
I'm different, yeah, I'm different. Pull up to the scene with my ceiling missing.
If I see you live and you suck, I don't want to listen to you ever again. I mean, honestly, when you do it so much, man, you start to feel repetitive and you start to feel like it becomes daunting, so you want to not do it anymore. So, I mean, like, dude, I started having mad head pains towards the end of 2012 just because I was fucking required to, like, bang my head for 60 minutes, you know what I'm saying? People did not want to see me stay still. So, I mean, I'm kind of mad at the turn-up stigma, but I also, you know, stupidly created for myself, like, when I put out videos of me banging the shit out of my head, and people, it's a gift and a curse, motherfucker. It's a catch 22. I know I lose and lose on both sides, but fuck it, two tears in a bucket. I didn't feel it at first. I wasn't like into it at first, you know what I'm saying? Just because I walked into it, and I was like, I thought it would be something different, you know. But now I really love it because French pop too.
Right.
So now it's not like it wasn't like all eyes on me. Like, what's he gonna do now? It's kind of like they got two people in two different lanes, and I have like a co-label mate. You know what I'm saying? That it's cool when we see each other out because we always hold each other down. So now it's more like a family feel because it's actually other people that are, you know, going through what I'm going through right now. You know what I'm saying? It was weird when it was just me on there because I was just floating alone and shit. And now that French is here, it's cool. Man, I think my dream song just happened.
Hey, yo, Floss, man, I think it's time, man. Let's bring it back for the city. We got one, man. Cleveland, we got one. Now, myself, Machine Gun Kelly, Ray Jr., Dubbo, Tezo, Pooh Gutter, JP. Hey, Floss.
You ready?
Drop that.
This one's for the Ratchet, Ratchet.
Music video drops at 10 o'clock.
Ratchet, Ratchet.
I told y'all a secret.
Tonight! Tonight, your video drops tonight! Yeah. Let's go! This is your official Radio World premiere, DJ Steph Floss. Machine Gun Kelly is in the building. Lace up, you meow.
Like you don't know what I need, bitch. Hennessy and this.
I think that's a song with all the artists from Cleveland that are hot, produced by a cat from Cleveland, mixed by one of my, you know what I'm saying, my brother Slim from Cleveland, you know what I'm saying? Like that whole song, the whole Ratchet joint was a dream for me because also it showed a side that people need to see of myself, you know what I'm saying? Which is like, yo, before people even knew about me outside of Cleveland, you know what I'm saying? I was really out here grinding it's grinding. I'm not like, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, people take like just Wikipedia facts and just think they know my life, you know what I'm saying? So when I get a chance to just shut everybody the fuck up and just, you know what I'm saying? Real does not co-sign fake. So real only co-signs real. So when you have, you know, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15, 30, fucking how many ever many people, 50 real Cleveland motherfuckers in the building at one time and no drama happens, it's all love, it's all respect, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's some priceless shit. So, I mean, Ratchet is what I'm fucking with because it's something different from me. And it's, you know, it's something that the streets want to hear, and it's something that's, you know, close to home. Man, I'm dropping a tape and I'm dropping an album. And that shit's not gonna be shit to play with, motherfucker. So, I mean, I'm not gonna, like, last year I was fucking Mr. Talk Everything Up and just, you know what I'm saying? All talking up does is disappoint, so I'm not gonna say shit. I got a tape dropping and a motherfucking album dropping. And the last album I dropped was fucking awesome, so you need to motherfucking hear that. Lace up. The funniest moment in the Ratchet video shoot, I mean, there was multiple, but the funniest one, because it was like the most life-threatening, was when there was a scene where everyone just pulled out their straps and shit. Oh, you know what I'm talking about? Everyone pulls out their straps and shit. So everyone was like, bitch, I'm Cleveland. I invited one of my homies to the shoot, and he was down there, but we hadn't seen each other in a while, so we started drinking and shit. And so this motherfucker gets really drunk, because I guess he doesn't drink, he only smokes. So this motherfucker gets really drunk. And like he sees he's late for the scene, but he got a gun, so he, you know what I'm saying, he wanted to get in the scene, so he runs to get in the scene. But like everyone got their guns out, this motherfucker runs sloppy drunk with his pistol just waving like this, bitch, I'm clear. And the motherfucker's like, but he's like pointing it everywhere. Right. Motherfucker's like, oh, 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 oh. And then motherfucker's like, dog, is that, what the, is that loaded? Is there bullet, there's bullets in that? What the fuck is wrong with you? Like that? This motherfucker's like, he's like, this motherfucker's like, oh, shit, it is loaded. Hold on. All right. You know what I'm saying? So that shit was funny because everyone in the video was like, oh, and everyone behind the camera was like, man, let's just move to behind, like, let's just leave just the cameraman at risk. Let's just delete the risk so we all move this. That shit was funny as fuck, though. Mario, mushrooms. Machine Gun Kelly, Dubbo, Cleveland. That Machine Gun Kelly wear. Did you get on our site? We're at Hot Topic. I really like, damn, who did I wear to the red carpet? Alexander Gautier. I really like him, man. He's, man, that motherfucker's fly, man. He made me a custom leather vest. That shit was sick. And then jeans, man. I wear like one brand of jeans now. I wear Rue jeans and shit. You know, that was cool. Have we fucked? No.
Angela Yee.
No.
So what's the deal with you and Angela Yee?
I popped my thumb in her butt? Not yet, man.
But you want to?
Yes, I want to fucking...
So look, we got this camera right now. She's going to watch this video. Talk to Angela Yee.
Angela Yee, I just want you to check my mic. Testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2. And talk into it like a dirty little whore. And receive my feedback.
If you catch my drift.